continuation of
one more disease caused by protozoan parasite. Name of the disease is
second disease caused by protozoan parasite. Name of the disease is amebiasis. Few points already studied in a last hour. Name of the disease is amebiasis. Then second step. The second step is particularly which protozoan parasite causes amebiasis? Ant amoeba causative agent. Our name of the protozoan is Ant amoeba histolytica. Ant amoeba histolytica causative agent. Then third step, mode of no need to take the incubation period. Mode of infection or mode of transmission. How amebiasis disease is transmitted? Already we know here which like structure? Cyst like structure or cysts are discharged. Cysts are discharged or released from the intestine through the fecal matter and contaminate the cyst containing intestinal discharge. It falls on the water, then contaminate the water, or maybe contaminate the food, especially the cysts are released from the intestinal discharge. Sir, how these cysts reached to the food, or how these cysts will be reached to the vegetable, or how these cysts will be reached to the any food atom? Mainly, who is a mechanical barrier or who is a carrier? The cysts are released from the intestinal discharge, and such a cysts reached to the food, or maybe reached to the vegetable and contaminate the food and contaminate the vegetable. Who is the mechanical carrier? How cysts reached to the food and contaminate the food and vegetable? Mainly these cysts are transmitted with the help of housefly. Housefly is a carrier. It transmits the cyst, and such cysts are reached to the food. And food, okay, which one is contaminated? Food is contaminated, vegetable is contaminated. Unknowingly, which containing? Cysts. The cysts are deposited on the food or vegetable. Such a cyst containing vegetable or food is consumed, and these cysts are entered in our body and affects the multiply their number and affect which organ in amoebiasis is large intestine is a affected organ. It is followed by directly move towards the sign and symptoms. Name the symptoms
observed in a amoebiasis. First symptom, mild diarrhea. Mild diarrhea. Mild diarrhea means just slight loose motion. Slight loose motion, mild diarrhea. It is followed by abdominal pain. Abdominal pain. Abdominal pain. Then particularly lower abdominal pain is called, lower abdominal pain is called constipation. Lower abdominal pain is called constipation. Then next one, and next particularly here there is a cramps. Sir, what is the meaning of a cramps? Cramps. Cramps means involuntary contraction of rectal muscle. Involuntary contraction of rectal muscle. What type of muscle? Rectal muscles. Involuntary. Involuntary contraction of rectal muscle, particularly during bowel movement. During a bowel movement. Bowel means nothing but a bowel means fecal matter. The waste matter is discharged, waste material is released through the rectum during during the moment contraction of the muscles, rectal muscles, involuntary contraction of the rectal muscle, especially during bowel movement. Bowel means nothing but a number two movement. Okay, number two movement, what happens here? Slight pain during bowel movement. For example, such a symptoms will be appear and immediately approaches to doctor and does doctor interact with you? How many times visited to so and so room? You say, sir, more than 5 times. Then second, whether completely liquid or mucus? Sir, along with liquid there is a slight mucus. Then cramps means during bowel movement, rectal pain called cramps. In severe cases, then move towards another symptom. In severe cases, one more symptom appeared in a amoebiasis disease. In severe cases, there is a mucus. Which containing mucus? That fecal matter is also called as a stool. Baitne ka stool nahi hai. Number two ko stool bolte. Aur ek another word mein. Stool. Which containing stool? There is a sumbala. Where sumbala? Mucus. Then, along with this, blood clot. These are the few symptoms appeared in a patient. He is suffering from which disease here? Amoebiasis. Second, protozoan disease in human being is amoebiasis. How many diseases finished? 2 diseases studies finished caused by protozoan. One of the diseases caused by protozoan, first disease is malaria. Malaria disease is caused by Plasmodium. Second protozoan disease is amoebiasis caused by Entamoeba histolytica. Then sir, what is the next step here? How to control or how to prevent amoebiasis? Special necessary to maintain the clean wherein proper that preventive method or controlling method. Controlling or preventive method, how to control amoebiasis disease, necessary to maintain that are proper sanitary facilities, necessary to maintain the cleanliness wherein sanitary either may be public sanitary or may be individual sanitary. Then
hands are washed with the before touch to that food or any other food items. Hands are washed with antiseptic soap or antiseptic liquid. Hands are washed properly. Hands are washed with the help of antiseptic, either may be liquid or may be soap, and later removed with the help of a kerchief. Means completely there is a free from pathogens. These are the two most important controlling measures. They are helping control the which disease here? Amoebiasis. Then how many diseases remains? Sir, another three diseases. The two diseases caused by helminthus, commonly called as roundworm. They belong to which phylum? Roundworms belonging to Ascelminthus. Ascelminthus is one of the phylum where in a non-chordate or invertebrates. But before come to the next disease caused by helminthus, the question, who named the scientist who is commonly called as the father of biology? Who is the father of biology? Theophrastus is known as the father of botany. Who is known as the father of biology? Aristotle is known as the father of biology. Then who is known as the father of medicine? Father of medicine. Question to all my online classes viewers, he is named as a father of medicine. Already his name is taken in a initial study of this chapter. Hippocrates, who is known as a father of medicine. Hippocrates is known as a father of medicine. Then next, how many bacteria causes a pneumonia disease? Already first group we know that here, Streptococcus pneumonia. In another way it is also called Diplococcus pneumonia. And one more bacteria is also capable to cause a pneumonia, that Haemophilus influenza. Already the Haemophilus influenza and para influenza, these two terms are taken during study of biotechnology. At the time of discussion of biotechnology, especially, are you heard the one of the terminology? There is a restriction endonucleases. These restriction endonucleases are the enzyme. These enzymes are used in cutting the DNA. So in which side they are ready to act? They are ready to act on such a region where palindromic sequence. What type of sequence? Palindromic sequence. Means, sir, why you entered this enzyme, or why you unnecessarily taken this terminology? Means Haemophilus influenza, para influenza. How many restriction endonucleases are isolated? Till today, it is possible to isolate approximately how many restriction endonucleases? 900 restriction endonucleases are isolated from how many strains? How many strains of bacteria? 230. From these 230 strains of bacteria, how many restriction endonucleases are isolated, including Haemophilus para influenza? But sir, why you are unnecessarily taken that term? Means name of the bacteria is Haemophilus influenza, also causes which disease here? Pneumonia.
The next, sir, only the two diseases caused by protozoan parasite Already we have an idea. Name the two diseases caused by protozoan parasite means. One of the disease is, first disease caused by protozoan parasite in human being is, in human being is malaria. Second protozoan disease in human being is, already just studied or just finished. Name of the disease is, name of the disease is amoebiasis. Amoebiasis and the next malaria, these two diseases caused by protozoa. But especially here malaria is caused by plasmodium and amoebiasis is caused by Entamoeba histolytica. Have any idea other diseases caused by protozoan parasite in human being? Are you heard the word Kala Azar? Kala Azar. Kala Azar in note point. In a note point. Kala Azar. Kala Azar. Kala Azar is a one more. Kala Azar is a one more protozoan disease in human being. Caused by particularly which protozoan is Leishmania donovani. Leishmania donovani is the name of the protozoa causes which disease here? Kala Azar. One more. Name the disease caused by African sleeping sickness. African sleeping sickness. Trypanosoma gambiens. Trypanosoma gambiens is a one more protozoa. Means totally common along with the malaria, amoebiasis, other two diseases also caused by protozoa in human being. Kala Azar. Kala Azar is caused by Leishmania donovani. Then African sleeping sickness, it is caused by Trypanosoma gambiens. Trypanosoma gambiens. Next, move towards the Hermintas study. Hermintas roundworms. Roundworms belonging to which phylum? Ascalmintas. Helminthus. They are commonly called as, they belong into class, they are also called as nematodes, belonging to phylum Ascalmintas. Name Helminthus disease in a human being or man is Ascariasis. Ascariasis is the first disease caused by Helminthus or roundworm. Then, particularly, which Helminthus causes ascariasis? Causative agent is Ascaris lumbricoides. Ascaris lumbricoides is the name of the causative agent. Then, when we enter incubation period is approximately 2 months. Incubation period of ascariasis in human being is 2 months. It is followed by mode of infection. How this disease is spread from one person to another person or from infected person to the, already you know all diseases belonging to which category? All these diseases belonging to already taken here. During initial step only, the diseases are arranged in how many categories? Diseases are arranged in two categories. Infectious diseases and infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. Infectious diseases are also called as communicable diseases. And second category is non-communicable diseases. Those diseases are easily spread from one person to another person. They are called communicable diseases. Communicable diseases, which is also communicable diseases. Which is also communicable disease here. Ascariasis is also communicable disease, or in another way it is called as infectious. Ascariasis disease also easily transmitted from one person to another person. Then mode of infection or mode of transmission, how this disease either spread from one person to another person, how? Have any idea? So before here to start the mode of infection, sir, name the affected organ in the small intestine. Affected organ is a small intestine. Then sir, how this disease is transmitted? This disease is transmitted through contaminated. This disease is transmitted through contaminated food or contaminated water or contaminated vegetable, etc. Then next affected organ is a small intestine. Especially, how many different types of ascaris? Especially remember here, there is a morphological differences are seen in a male ascaris and a female ascaris. Female ascaris is a larger than the male one. Then directly move toward the female ascaris is larger than sexual dimorphism is different. Male is smaller than the female. Which one is larger? Female ascaris is larger than the male. Which is ready? Female ascaris ready to lace. What type of egg is laid by the female ascaris? Fertilized egg, and it help in a ready to fertilized egg. It help in, sir. How many fertilized eggs laid by or produced by single female ascaris? Means it is capable 15,000 to 2 lakh. How many eggs? 15,000 it is capable. They are either maybe capable to produce us a 15,000 egg, or maybe they are capable to produce us a how many lakh here? 2 lakh egg is produced by the single female ascaris. Then it help in a multiply the number wherein affected organ is a small intestine, where it help in a multiplication of which parasite? Ascaris. Then one more. Next, when we concentrate, for example, we view that here one of the infected host cell. One of the infected host cell, this contains how many parasite? Means approximately there is a 500 to 5000. Single infected host contains how many other helminths or how many parasites here? 500 to 5000. Kitne parasite? What is the number here? 500 to 5000 parasites are present in a single host cell. Then next, when multiply the number within the which are here small intestine, Then affected organ from the herpes is small intestine. Then one by one symptoms will be appear. Especially the symptoms will be appear where in children's or in children. Sir, name the few symptoms studied in ascariasis or helminthus. First symptom already we know that the target organ is small intestine. First symptom, sign and symptom, sign and symptoms of which disease? Already mentioned here. Name of the disease is ascariasis. Particularly which helminthus causes ascaris lumbricoid. Second, the incubation period is how many months? Approximately 2 months. Then, how this disease is transmitted? This disease is mainly transmitted through contaminated soil, contaminated food, contaminated water, and contaminated vegetable. Already, that where the parasite is present, the parasite present in this atom. Then, secondly, the affected organ is mentioned. Then, which is now female ascaris. Female ascaris produces how many eggs? Female ascaris, single female ascaris, if it is present in an intestinal cross cell, it is capable to produce how many egg here? How many egg here? 15,000 to 2 lakh. 15,000 egg to 2 lakh. Fertilized, not unfertilized. Fertilized egg is laid by single female ascaris where in a intestine. Then each host cell contains approximately how many? 500 to 5,000. Then it is followed by sign and symptoms observed in a patient. That first here, internal bleeding due to infection from which species here? Ascaris lumbricoid. Internal bleeding is a first symptom. Internal bleeding. It is followed by muscular pain. Internal bleeding. It is followed by muscular pain. Then next slight fever. Anemia. Anemia means deficiency of oxygen. That is called anemia due to reduction in RBC. Then next most important symptom in patient. Especially in children, I am discussing about it. छोटे हैं जब क्या बोलते थे तुम? डब्बा लेके बाहर गए. किधर गए? छोटे हैं जब डब्बा लेके बाहर गए क्या बोलते थे? उससे पास हो जाते थे कोई ऐसा. उससे पास आते ना बोलते थे ना छोटे हैं जब क्या बोलते थे? देखो रे देखो उससे क्या क्या निकल आते हैं? Helminthus निकल आते बोल के बोलते थे. तो यहाँ पर ये commonly this disease is seen in a children. Anemia is followed by blockage of intestinal passage. क्या block हो गया यहाँ पर? Intestine block हो गया due to accumulation of which parasite? Due to accumulation of which parasite? Ascaris lumbricoid, which is blocked. Intestine, small intestine or large intestine? Small intestine is a blocked. Then it is mainly affect on the, again directly or indirectly it affect on the children, especially it affect on growth. The infected person show that stunted growth. Stunted means due to the infection of ascaris lumbricoid. These are the few signs and symptoms observed in a patient who is suffering from ascariasis. Have any doubt about the ascariasis? Then it is followed by one more helminthus disease in human being. Name the second helminthus disease in human being is Elephantiasis. It is also called Elephantiasis is also called as. Second helminthus disease in human being is elephantiasis. Elephantiasis. It is also called. Elephantiasis is also called as filariasis. Filariasis. Second disease caused by helminthus in human being is elephantiasis. Particularly, which helminthus causes a filariasis or elephantiasis? Name of the helminthus is Wuchereria belcrofti. Wuchereria belcrofti. Wuchereria belcrofti. In another way, it is also called as. In another way, it is also called. Then, Wuchereria belcrofti and Wuchereria. Wuchereria. Wuchereria malai. Malaya malai. 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 Wuchereria belcrofti and Wuchereria malai. Then, next. Affected organs are. Before here, before to start the affected organ, and so first to concentrate on incubation period. Incubation period. Incubation period. Incubation period is approximately how many months? 8 to how many months here? 8 to 16 month. It is followed by how this disease is transmitted. Mode of infection or mode of transmission. Mode of transmission or mode of infection. Mode of transmission or mode of infection. Especially, this disease is transmitted from infected person to healthy person. Infected person to healthy person through mosquito bite. Name the mosquito. That is act as a. Are you heard that one more terminology? We want to remember here. Number of time along with restriction in those languages. Which terminology is also commonly used? Vector. Vector. Not a vector and scalar. Vector and scalar. No need to take the physics study here. Instead of physics, concentrate toward the biology study. Vector means. Vector. They are commonly called as a molecular vehicle. They are ready to carry parenchyme. Vectors are the vectors. Vector means nothing but a plasmid. Who is known as a vector? Who is commonly called as a vector? Plasmids are commonly called as vectors. Plasmid, they are capable to carry the gene from one organism to another organisms. Hence, they are also called as molecular vehicles. Who is commonly called as a molecular vehicle? Vector. Name the vector that involved in a transmission of elephantiasis or filariasis. Name the vector. Name of the vector is mosquito. Which mosquito? Male mosquito or female? Female mosquito, not a male mosquito. Through female mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito? No, sir. Female Culex mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito is involved in. It is act as a vector wherein transmission of which disease? Malaria. Name the vector involved in transmission of malaria disease means female Anopheles mosquito. Name the vector or name the mosquito involved in the transmission of which disease? Elephantiasis. How elephantiasis disease is transmitted from infected person to healthy person? Through which bite? Through female which mosquito? Culex mosquito is act as a female. Culex mosquito is act as a vector. Wherein which disease here? Filariasis transmission. But which mosquito is act as a vector in malarial transmission? Female Anopheles mosquito. Then again I want to remind you here. Name the other two diseases transmitted with the help of Aedes mosquito, not AIDS. Please don't confuse AEDS. One more mosquito, it is act as a vector. Through this vector only the two diseases are transmitted. As you know here, ನಿಮ್ಮನೆ ಯಾರಲ್ಲ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಅಜ್ಜ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತಾರ ಅವರು ನನ್ನ ಮಳಕಾಲ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾಕ ಇಲಿಗಳ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ? ಇಲಿಗಳ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣದ ಚಿಕನ್ ಗುನಿಯ. Chicken gunia and dengue. Chicken gunia and dengue are the two diseases. They are transmitted through which mosquito? Aedes mosquito. Aedes mosquito, chicken gunia and dengue are the two diseases transmitted with the help of which mosquito? Aedes mosquito. But elephantiasis through Culex mosquito. No need to repeat. Then move toward the next step. Sir, how female Culex mosquito it help in a transmission of this disease? Example already in the neck here. Female Culex mosquito. This female Culex mosquito it ready to give birth to there is a one of the war. That which stage है? Juvenile stage. सर समझ में नहीं आया. Female Culex mosquito है, किनको बर्थ दे रहा है? वार्म को बर्थ दे रहा है. वो वार्म कौन सा स्टेज में है? Juvenile stage में है. मालूम हो गए? वो juvenile stage में है, सो वार्म को हम क्या बोलेंगे? Microfilaria बोलेंगे. क्या बोलेंगे? Microfilaria कौन सा स्टेज में है? वार्म है. वो वार्म कौन सा स्टेज में है? जीवेनाइल. उसको कौन बर्थ दिए? फीमेल क्यूलेक्स मस्किटो गिव्स बर्थ टू जीवेनाइल वार्म कॉल्ड एज माइक्रोफाइलेरिए. समझ में आया? माइक्रोफाइलेरिए कहां पर था? किनके बॉडी में था? किनके बॉडी में? इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन के बॉडी में से किनके बॉडी में आ गया? हेल्दी पर्सन. तो इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन से कैसा आ गया? इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन को कौन बाइट करे? फीमेल क्यूलेक्स मॉस्किटो बाइट करे. कौन सा पर्सन को? इन्फेक्टेड. ये मॉस्किटो के बॉडी के अंदर आए कौन? माइक्रोफाइलेरिया. जब ये क्यूलेक्स मॉस्किटो ने किनको बाइट करा? हेल्दी पर्सन को. और किनको इंजेक्ट कराया? वार्म को इंजेक्ट करें. देन वार्म इज रेडी टू अंडरगो डेवलप इन पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन. सो वेर इन अ हेल्दी पर्सन, बट हेल्दी पर्सन आल्सो बिकम्स अ इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन व्हेन ही बाइट्स फ्रॉम द फीमेल Culex mosquito. Female Culex mosquito inside that which one? Microfilaria into the healthy person, then he becomes infected. Then next, further development of microfilaria within the infected person. Then this filaria start to multiply within the human host. Then next, sir, how multiplies in their number and how these are parasites accumulate in our body, particularly in a lymphatic vessel. Particularly in a lymphatic vessel. Then, next step, they move from one region to other region, and where they are staying here. They move from, actually, when, for example, which mosquito? Culex mosquito bite to the infected person and inject it. This Culex mosquito inject the worm into there is a human body. Then with the help of a blood, this worm reached which organ here? This worm reached to target organ. Worm reached to target organ. And where it ready to? Here, in target organ only, it ready to stay. It shows the development. And start to multiply. More number of which are accumulated, more number of worms are accumulated. Where they are accumulated? More number of worms are accumulated. Where they are accumulated? They are accumulated at a vessel. Blood vessel or lymphatic vessel? Blood vessel or lymphatic vessel? Kunsa vessel ke andar jama ho gaye? Kunsa vessel ke andar jama ho gaye? Multiply ho gaye. Kin mein multiply ho gaye? Okay, war mein. Already war to kise throw aaya sir? Bolo to Culex mosquito throw se aaya. Malum ho gaya na? Culex mosquito ne bite kara. Kinko bite kar diya? Human ko. Jab unhone kisko inject kara? War ko. Kaun sa war ko? Kaun sa war hai idhar? Already bata de raha na kaun sa war hai? Fallopian war ko inject kara. Malum ho gaya? वो इंजेक्ट करे सो फाइलेरियन वाल किसके हेल्प से ब्लड के हेल्प से आके रीच हो गए. किधर आके रीच हो गए? टारगेट ऑर्गन को आके रीच हो गए. वहां पर हाल्ट करे, स्टे करे. कौन वाल स्टे करने के बाद और उसका फर्दर डेवलपमेंट चलते रहा. कौन सा ऑर्गन के अंदर? टारगेट ऑर्गन के अंदर. देन नेक्स्ट एंड स्टार्ट टू मल्टीप्लाई देयर नंबर. One start to multiply in that number where in a target organ. When more number of worms are accumulated, where they are accumulated? They are accumulated at a lymphatic vessel and a blockage of a lymphatic vessel. Kinka block ho gaya? Kin kon block ho gaya? For example, ab main dikha de rahe ho. A lymphatic vessel है. Lymphatic vessel के अंदर आके कौन आके जमा हो गए? ये worm है. कौन सा worm है? Fallopian worm है. Fallopian worm आके कहाँ पर है? ये vessel है. किसका vessel है? Lymphatic vessel के अंदर आके जमा हो गए. Take that many year. Say more number of fallopian worms where they are accumulated. They are accumulated in a lymphatic vessel and blockage of lymphatic vessel due to accumulation of more which worm here? Fallopian worm. After many year completely the which is blocked, lymphatic vessel is blocked. It leads to the about directly hum kidhar aayenge or before to start the sign and symptoms, please to concentrate on which organ affected organ. Have any doubt about this disease? First again once more I will repeat. Name of the disease is elephantiasis. Have any idea about the elephantiasis? Elephantiasis, or it is also called as a filariasis. Lower limbs. Lower arm becomes a swelling in the lower limbs due to infection of which worm here? Filarial worm. Name the filarial worm that causes elephantiasis means Wacheria bancrofti. It is also called Wacheria malai. Wacheria malai. Then affected organ. Name the affected organ from this disease is? Name the affected organ is limbs. Limbs are the affected organ. And not only limbs, along with limbs then the genital organ. Genital means the organs involved in a reproduction called genital organ. Genital organ may be example of that here. Genital organ may be means scrotum. Scrotum is a genital organ. Damages to which is damages or which affected filarial worm affect to limbs. Upper limbs or lower limbs? Lower limbs. Then not only lower limbs and also affects to the genital organ like a scrotum. Then, sir, how this disease is transmitted? Which disease is transmitted? Elephantiasis. For example, infected person. The infected person contains a which worm? In the body of the infected person, which worm is present? Filarial worm is present. In such a cases, which is bites? Culex mosquito. Culex mosquito bites to which person? Infected person. In the body of infected person, which worm is present? Filarial worm. Such a filarial worm is entered in the body of which mosquito? Culex mosquito. Then such a infected culex mosquito ready to infect which person here? Healthy person. And inject the which worm here? Filarial worm. Already mentioned here, particularly which worm? Microfilariae. That is in which stage? Juvenile stage. Microfilariae is injected into which person here? Healthy person. Then microfilariae ready to move with the help of blood and reached to target organ where it ready to stay many days and in such a organ it ready to undergo developmental also takes place where in a target organ. Then start to multiply the number after many years, what happens? More number of worms are where they are accumulated? They are accumulated in a lymphatic vessel. Due to living of filarial worm in a lymphatic vessel, lymphatic vessel get a blocked or blockage of lymphatic vessel due to accumulation of more number of which worm here? Filarial worm in the body of infected person. Well, the next last point. Sign and symptoms. Sir, name the symptoms appeared in a patient who is suffering from elephantiasis. Chronic inflammation. What is the meaning of chronic? Chronic means bole to kya hai? Chronic inflammation. Chronic bole to inflammation bole to kya hai? सर इन्फ्लेमेशन बोले तो स्वेलिंग, इन्फ्लेमेशन बोले तो क्या है स्वेलिंग, स्वेलिंग हो गए। क्यों स्वेलिंग हो गए? स्वेलिंग सडन हो गया क्या? धीरे धीरे से हो गए। क्रोनिक मीन्स स्वेलिंग इज सडनली अपीयर, नो सर, स्लोली स्वेलन, स्लोली स्वेलिंग, स्लोली स्वेलिंग इज कॉल्ड क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन। क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन मीन्स, क्रोनिक मीन्स सर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ क्रोनिक, क्रोनिक मीन्स क्रोनिक बोले तो क्या है ग्रेजुअल, नॉट ए सडन, थोड़ा 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 क्या हो गए स्वेलिंग होते गए। क्यों स्वेलिंग होते गया? ऑलरेडी इधर हो गए, देखो ब्लॉकेज हो गए। कौन ब्लॉकेज हो गए? लिम्फेटिक वेसल ब्लॉक होने से क्या होने स्टार्ट हो गया? लिम्फेटिक वेसल ब्लॉक होने से क्या स्टार्ट हो गया? स्वेलिंग स्टार्ट हो गया। स्वेलिंग या सडनली या स्लोली, स्लोली मीनिंग क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ, क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ, क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन इन, क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन इन अभी चार दिन, क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन इन अभी चार दिन, क्रोनिक इन्फ्लेमेशन इन अभी चार दिन इन्फेक्टेड ऑर्गन ड्यू टू सर्वाइव, ड्यू टू सर्वाइव, इंस्टेड ऑफ सर्वाइव इट टेक इट ए लाइव, लाइव ऑफ, लाइव ऑफ ए विच वन ऑफ ए, लाइव ऑफ ए वन, हाउ मेनी, मेनी एयर, विच लिव्स मेनी एयर, वार लिव्स मेनी एयर, कौन लिव, कौन यहां पर स्टे करे, समझ में आ रहा है? What is the first? Chronic inflammation. Slowly inflammation in a which organ? Infected organ. So why chronic inflammation or slow swelling will be appear? Due to living or survival of a warm many year in this organ. Then second symptom. Second, it leads to the gas increase. Gas increase, totally increase in the, increase, gas means totally increase in the, increase in a, which means here, increase in a lower, increase in the lower limbs, means lower limbs starts to swelling. Not only lower limbs, and completely. You remember here one. I want to write one of the most important one. That is called a deformation. What is the meaning of a deformation? Deformation is completely to change the structure of a which organ. To change the structure of which organ? कौन सा organ का थी? Genital organ में completely क्या हो गया? Deformation हो गया। completely क्या होने जा रहा है इधर? Changes होने जा रहा है। मैं आपको इधर देखो, ये दो scrotum है ना ये? क्या है ये? Scrotum है ना? बाहर है ना body से? Scrotum के अंदर कौन है? स्क्रोटम के अंदर कौन है? स्क्रोटम के अंदर टेस्टिस है। तो किनके साइज में? इसमें देखो ये आफ्टर इन्फेक्शन के बाद कंप्लीटली किनका चेंज हो गया? कंप्लीटली टू चेंज द ग्रास स्ट्रक्चर और डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए जेनिटल ऑर्गन ड्यू टू द इन्फेक्शन ऑफ विच वर्म एयर फाइलेरियल वर्म ऑफ फाइलेरिया। That name of the disease is called lower limbs are swollen due to blockage of lymphatic vessel.